In the next three sessions, we shall be talking about a different set of operators, namely the relational operators, the logical operators, and the equality and not equality operators. All these operators share one common thing. When they are used, the result happens to be either true or false. That means they give an answer whether it is yes or no. So let's take first the relational operators. The relational operators in C are greater than, lesser than, greater than or equal to, and lesser than or equal to. Now, these are very frequently used. Say for example, I want to compare two values. Let's say A has got 30 and B has got 40. So if I say if B greater than A in brackets, then it's going to tell me it's true or false. So relational operators are used to compare quantities in memory location. So if I say if A greater than B, the result of this is either going to be true or false. True is going to be a non-zero number, false is going to happen to be always zero. So the best way to understand the relational operator is to take a look at a very simple example on its usage. So here it is. I have a small piece of code where I have defined an integer variable A is equal to 20 and B is equal to 10. Then I have defined a third integer variable called as result, which is going to hold the result of the different comparisons I am going to perform with A and B. Now, suppose I say, forget this left hand side, suppose I say in bracket A less than or equal to B. Here 20 is definitely not less than nor equal to 10. So the result of this is going to be false. So this bracket is going to contain the answer 0. 0 is going to be copied to result. So when I print result, it's going to print a value 0. So the result of this comparison had to be either true or false. In this case, it happened to be false or 0. Let's do one more comparison here. Here I'm comparing is A greater than or equal to B. Okay, this is a simple expression in C. Anything like this is an expression. So I'm saying is A greater than or equal to B. Now 20 is definitely greater than 10. So the result is going to be true. So the answer in this bracket is going to come out as 1. 1 is going to be copied to result. So when I print f result, it's going to print 1. So this is how you go about using the relational operators for different operations. Their usage will be very clear when we go about dealing with control flow statements like if, else if, switch case, while, do while, for, and all those statements. Then you will be extensively using these relational operators along with logical operators and equality operators, giving you much more clarity on their usage.